What do we mean when we say empathy or compassion? It's not hard to see that there are several distinct issues. On the one hand, a psychopath doesn't really care about others, but may use their understanding of emotions to get what they want. While autistic people don't have an automatic understanding of others' emotions, even though they do care. On top of that, how sure you are of another person's feelings depends mostly on how vividly you imagine them, and not on how accurately you've perceived their emotions. So, what makes us care about others' feelings, and how do we even know what they're feeling in the first place? Suppose you walk by a homeless person on the street and you feel bad. In part, this will be your own personal distress at the situation, which has nothing to do with their emotional state at all, though you might give them 50 cents to take away your guilt. If you're too focused on alleviating your own distress, you'll simply avoid uncomfortable situations and not really try to grok the other person's mental state. In contrast, when you focus on their emotions, you can act altruistically and genuinely feel for them. This sympathy or compassion need not mean feeling the same as them, but rather feeling alongside. So, suppose you do want to know what someone else is feeling. How can you tell? Of course, you could ask them, but we're often expected to just know, and anyway, people often hide their feelings or don't consciously know them in the first place. So how do we find out? One approach is logical. You see someone smile, and since you know that people smile when they're happy, you can logically deduce that they must feel happy. This kind of conscious theoretical modeling, or theory, is something autistic people can learn quite well, though it's limited by the difficulty of learning all the nuances of emotional display. Another approach is to put yourself in the other person's shoes. By imagining how you would feel if you were homeless or if you had just reached the summit of Mount Everest, you can guess how someone actually in those situations might feel. But while this simulation theory is easy to do, it quickly breaks down if the other person's personality is different from yours, or if your ideas of life on the streets or at 30,000 feet are just skewed. In addition to these conscious processes, your brain has a kind of emotion reading reflex. As you look at another person, a part of your brain called the mirror neuron system automatically and unconsciously mirrors their facial expressions and body language. When you see a subtle facial expression, this system fires as if you were making the same movement, and you then sense the emotion associated with that expression. Usually, this mirroring is a purely internal response, but sometimes you'll unconsciously mimic other people's posture or facial expressions. Likewise, you can generally tell that the emotion isn't yours, but sometimes you'll experience emotional contagion, like starting to feel happy yourself just by being around someone else who's happy. This leakiness of your perception of others' emotions can actually be very helpful in social situations, as you subconsciously show others that you know how they feel by reflecting their emotions in your own behavior. We don't really yet understand how you distinguish your own emotions from your perception of others' emotions, or why and when this distinction breaks down, but what we do know points towards a new perspective on how we behave in social situations and how we distinguish ourselves from the people around us. If you liked this video, please share it and subscribe for updates. You can follow and contact us at Google+, Twitter, and Facebook, CogSai. To ask questions or suggest topics for future episodes, go to cogsai.com/Q.